Hey everyone, it's Darlene. Welcome back for another card video. Today's card uses the Best Fishes set by Simon Says Stamp. It is one of my very favorites. I've used it so many times. I'm also using these two MISTIs and I am giving away a mini MISTI today. So be sure to check out the blog for details on that. I'm going to start with stamping the fish. I'm going to place my MISTI in the landscape position and put my Nina cardstock in the lower left-hand corner and position my first fish as far to the right as I can. And that's going to be my first stamp. So I'll close that, get that guy on the lid. I'm going to be inking him up with some Memento Tuxedo Black ink because I'm coloring him with some Copic markers. And I'll just make sure my paper's in the corner and I will stamp him. I want all these fish to be exactly in a perfectly straight line. So I'll go ahead and ink him up again. And what I'm gonna do is move my paper an inch and a half to the right. Now I determined that an inch and a half was perfect for this particular fish. So you'll just kind of have to figure out what the best measurement is for the stamp image that you're using. So I'm just gonna do this one more time, ink it up with some Memento, and then I'll move my cardstock again an inch and a half to the right, and I will stamp it down. And that gives me three perfectly aligned fish. For my other one, I'm gonna start in the other corner. So I'm gonna move my cardstock to the right and position my fish all the way to the left edge. I'm gonna put my sentiment here just to make sure that I have enough distance between the two fish. And once I figure out I've got my fish in the right place, I'll go ahead and get him on the lid. And I'm actually gonna remove that sentiment because I'm gonna stamp that later. I just wanna do my fish now. So I'm gonna ink him up with some Memento Tuxedo Black ink, same ink, and then I will stamp him down. Now for this guy, I determined that an inch and an eighth was the way to go for this size fish. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move my cardstock an inch and an eighth. I'm moving it according to the ruler on the bottom. The MISTI is great because it has rulers on three different sides. So I'm gonna stamp him down and then I'm gonna repeat this two more times really quickly here so that I get an inch and an eighth down, stamp, and then one more time, ink it up, inch and an eighth to the left, and then stamp down. You can use this technique for any kind of image that you just want to get a straight line to create a pattern. For the sentiment, it's just going to be quick and easy using the MISTI. I'm going to use the same ink just to make things simple, and I like to do mine individually. I could have stamped these two words together, but I want as much visibility as I can to make sure that they're lined up. At the bottom of the card, I'm gonna stamp some grass, like kind of kelp in the water. I'm gonna use two different colors of green. The first one is Pear Pizzazz, and I'm just gonna use an acrylic block for this stamp, and I'm just gonna have some scratch paper underneath to make it easy for the cleanup. And there are three different lines of these that come with the stamp set, so I'm using just one with the Pear Pizzazz, and I'm flipping it over to make sure it doesn't look like it's the same one, and I'm varying the height. I'm also going to use Garden Green, just another green for some variation and interest. And I just pulled another one of those grass pieces. And again, I'm randomly putting them in there for sides and flipping it over when I need to. I'm going to add some color to the bottom and the top edges of this panel just to soften all that white space that's around all these different images. So I have a sponge dauber and I'm using Pear Pizzazz, which is that lighter color that I use for the green. And I'm doing a very, very little bit at the very bottom edge because they're supposed to be in the ocean, but I want there to be some green because of the grass that's coming up. Next, I'm going to take some tumbled glass distress ink, again a sponge dauber, and the reason why I chose this particular color is because it is a very, very light blue, and I didn't want there to be too bright of a color which will distract from the fish that I'm going to color in just a minute here. So I went over the green and up a little bit just till I hit the bottom of the fish. And then for the top, I used that same tumbled glass, and I just wanted to make sure I didn't have any green on my dauber before I started using it. And I did this very slowly. I'm gonna speed it up, but I did tiny little circles, and I'm using a sponge dauber instead of an ink foam applicator because I wanted it to be really, really light, and I was afraid I might get too much with the rectangular foam applicator. So I started really small and light, and then I decided to go a little further down with the blue. It's always best to start light because you can always add more color, but it's much harder, if not impossible, to get this taken off your paper. So I went a little further down, and then I decided to add a little bit more color at the top, and so I sort of played around with it until I got it the way I wanted it. Now it's time for coloring fish. I have YG09 and YG06, and I started way too quickly. So I realized that I colored the wrong stripe. With this pattern, his face would be green, and I knew I didn't want that, but I also knew I didn't want to stamp everything all over again. So I decided to move on and go back to this in a little bit. Starting over with the next one, I'm going to color the top and the bottom edges with the darker YG09. The area is really small here, so that's why I'm just going to use two colors. And then I'll take my YG06, and I'm just going to fill in the gap between those two lines and blend it out between the two colors. I'm going to go ahead and do that for all of the fish. And now I'm going to go back in and do the fins. I'm just going to do them really simply with a little dot of the YG09 on all the different areas. And I'll do the bottom of that back fin with the dark one. And then I take my YG06 and just fill in whatever white is left and blend the two colors together. You can see I went over the line there, but it's not a big deal. I'm going to be coloring it with a different color later, and it'll blend that color right back over the line. After completing all of that coloring, I decided to revisit the mistake. And so I decided to stamp it again on a piece of cardstock and color it the same way. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this guy out later, and I'm going to glue him right on top. For the white areas of the fish, I wanted to give it still some dimension, even though it's just white. So I took my C1, which is a very cool light gray, and I colored in the top and bottom portions of the fish and underneath kind of his nose and under his mouth there a little bit. And once I'm done with the C1, I'll take a 0. And what that'll do is I'll blend the line where the C1 ends and push that C1 to the edge. So that way it gives it a nice shaded perspective without really changing the color from white. And I'm going to do that on all these fish, including the one that I stamped separately. And I have a few more details. So the first one is taking my 0, and I'm just gonna make a little dot in the center of where that lighter green was and on the top of his back fin. And this will kind of add just a little bit more of a tiny reflection and make him look a little bit more rounded. Before I add my last detail, I decided to go ahead and cut this guy out and adhere him to the top. So I decided to use the two-way glue pen because I knew it wouldn't squeeze too much glue out and seep out the side, and I wanted to make sure I got in all the little corners of this fish so it didn't look like he was glued on. So I grabbed my tweezers and placed him on top, and because I used glue, I was able to kind of wiggle it around a little bit until it was right on top of that original image, and I don't think you can tell at all. All right, finally for my last detail, I'm going to use my Uniball Signo White gel pen. It's my favorite gel pen, but the thing is it's got a broad tip, so it's pretty thick. When I apply it, it's going to be hard to get a small dot. So I kind of got a little hole in the middle of my dots on a lot of these dots, and you'll see in the close-up photo on the blog post. But it actually looks good, like it's made to be like that, because it makes the fish look a little bit more natural, like it's real scales instead of just some white dots. So I added these white dots to all the fish. I like adding these little details because I think it makes a really big difference in the finished product. Now it's time for the blue fish. I'm just using two colors again. I have B02, which is my darker blue color, and B000. I just colored the back of the fish with the dark color and then the front of the fish with the lighter color. I did his fins the same way with the two colors. For his detail, I'm going to take a marker that's a shade darker. So I'm using B05. Remember, I had colored this B02, and I'm just going to dot where the B02 was colored initially. And that'll make my dots stand out a little bit more than if I were to use the tone on tone. So wherever there's B02, I'm going to put B05. And then I'm going to take B02 and I'm going to dot where I had colored the B000, which was my lightest blue. And I'm going to make them a little bit spaced out more as I get closer to the head. And I'm going to stop about halfway, maybe a little bit further, and leave the rest without dots on the front of the fish. I'm going to do this on all three fish. It's really amazing how tiny of a dot you can get from these markers because they really have a fine tip. Finally, I'm going to put some tape runner on the back of this panel, and I'm going to grab my MISTI again. This time I'm going to use the mini. I switch back and forth between using these. I use them both. And so I'm going to take out the black foam piece and put my card base in the lower left-hand corner. I'll hold my panel slightly above my base until I hit the corner. Once I hit the corner, then I can press my panel down, and I'll be sure to get a mat that's exactly perfect with my card base. And that is the card for today. So I hope you enjoyed that, and be sure to check out the blog post on how to win a mini MISTI. And I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.